to tell everybody this is your song. It may be quiet, simple, but now that it's done, feel you're so fine. When we touch the sky, me and you, this is mine.
Hello, well, I'm at Botany Bay in Kent, not too far from Dover, and I'm out wild camping. It's the first time I've been out since before lockdown. Strangely enough, the last time I went out wild camping was with Tom from Tom Outdoors and Mark from First Class Adventures, and I'm actually with Tom again today. It's been a very, very hot day today. We've got the tents pitched. I'll give you a little tour of the tents a bit later on, and I shall speak to you later and tell you what we've been up to. Take care for now. Well, the little beastie finally had her outing after being waterproofed. This is my 1980s Millets Scout tent. As you can see, there's a spelling mistake on the actual label on the tent itself, but on the bag it's in, it's got the correct spelling. I'm dating this somewhere to around the early to mid 80s, because I know after that I had better tents. Saying that, she did well last night. She was fine for me. There's a little view inside. Just had a very light Mountain Warehouse Traveller 50 sleeping bag, but I was amply warming that. It's been a warm night last night. It was a very, very hot day yesterday. And yeah, had a had about a couple of hours kip at max. I was up until about 2:30 talking to Tom, doing some photography with him, and got into the sort of sleeping bag, but didn't really sleep properly last night. And then woke up about 5:30 and saw the sunrise. And here is Mr. Tom Outdoors.
Oh no.
Would you like to give us a quick talk through of your tent?
Yeah, so it's a Pro Action Tiger Paws one person tent. They no longer manufacture this tent, so they're quite sought after. You can pick them up on eBay and the like. I think I got this for, I want to say around 30 quid, something like that. But when I originally bought one, because this was like, this model was the first tent I ever owned, I got it for about 24, and it was bright orange. And likewise, I got rid of it and bought this one sometime this year during the lockdown. And I love it. It's good for beach camps. Weighs about 1.9 kilos. Guy lines are a bit bright, but it's a sturdy little tent. Aluminium poles, air vent, and then Velcro storm flap. The zips aren't bad on it. Quite a nice sized porch area.
Cool.
And it's got like a bathtub floor on it, and then quite a lot of space inside as well. Tons of room in there.
Oh wow, that's massive.
Yeah, you can comfortably sit up in it.
Yeah, it's got a lot more head height than my old little thing, hasn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, brilliant. Plenty of room in there.
Superb. Thank you very much, Tom. As you can tell, he's a professional. He did a much, much better review of his tent than I did of mine.
That was good.
Brilliant. Thanks, Tom. Cheers.
Right,
that's about it. Going to sit here and enjoy the scenery now for a while and probably have a drink. Speak to you a bit later. Bye. Right, so we're packed up, ready to go. As you can see, there's no trace of where we've been. We've got our bags packed up and we've got our rubbish packed away. Not that we generated a lot of rubbish, we've got a couple of plastic bottles in there and a drinks can, I think, and some wrappers from some cereal bars and some file that the sandwiches are wrapped up in. So, thanks for watching and hope to see you soon. Cheers, bye.